Today we'll be talking about, for the first course, just dive deep into a little more about using the Flexbox display in HTML. This is a new way of creating very, very responsive and grids and layout, and it's actually really easy. So this is a demo that will feature just the basics of Flexbox. So let's assume that I'm starting my web page from scratch. I do not want to use Bootstrap. I do not want to use any other grid layout structure. I want to be able to figure out how to create my own custom layout using Flexbox. And here's the code, and I just want you to go through down here. Here's basically the code here. Here's all these div objects, as you can see here, and I've used just the basic CSS to actually color these divs, so you can clearly see what how are we going to actually create a layout, a nice simple layout for us. So basically, in this case, how I start off is I just create a bunch of divs, and by default, their display, this is called display block, they take up the whole width of the browser, and they stack on top of each other. And that's, by default, how everything works. Now, so how I would change this from the default display to from a block display to a flex display is really just this one line of code here in my container object. Also, I need to make sure that we have a container object here. This is actually really crucial to do. So a lot of web developers use a one div to contain everything else, so it allows them to control a lot of the rest of the elements down here. So in my container object, element, I will go and actually uncomment this and save this, and now I refresh, and this is flex. So this is what it looks like now, and you're like, wait a minute, what just happened? Flex, by default, tries to put everything in, instead of like a horizontal mode, it lines up everything in a more vertical mode. So basically, what we've done is, in one line of code, we were able to lay out all of our divs side by side instead of stacked on top of each other. Now, sometimes and you're like, all right, well, that's fine. That's kind of, it kind of mimics a grid layout structure, but I want to be able to control the layout a little more. Is there a way to control the layout? And there is, it's called Flex Wrap. There's an option in CSS that's called Flex Wrap. So let's put the wrapping feature. And here we go. So basically, it goes back to what we've seen before. Like with Flex Wrap, it actually, if the element doesn't fit on one row, it actually wraps around the whole web page. Well, then you figure out, well, Mark, this doesn't, I want to be able to like control, like I want weather and advertisement to line up side by side. So how do I do that? And the key is to learn Flex, and display Flex and the display Flex Wrap gives you the basic foundation in order for you to be able to control the width of your elements. So let's say, okay, I want to be able to have, you know, green, let's assume that this is my weather applet and my advertisement, they'll be side by side, and they'll each take up 50% of my width of my browser. Same thing, I want my gray and my yellow, my related article, and my another related article, I want them to appear side by side as well. So we just set the width. And Flexbox, right here, this is magic. In a couple of steps, I'm able to create somewhat of a layout already. And as you can see, this is pretty fast. You can say like, well, Mark, like this is great, but I want to be able to have a very flexible layout in, say, if a person were to load this up in a mobile device. So basically, if I were to resize this, as you see, I'm resizing this right now. This is basically the size of a typical mobile phone. But you don't want them to look at this tiny weather section here and a tiny advertising section. You actually want them to think about, okay, let me just, is there a way for me to go ahead and like lay out everything stacked on top in my mobile when my viewport is this width, and then like have the weather advertisement, the related article, and the another related article, the green, the gray, yellow, and the green and red side by side when a user is using a bigger screen. There is, it's called media queries, and you've learned that in HTML CSS. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a logic that says like, if the width is greater than 360 pixels, if this is greater than 360 pixels, I'm gonna have the green, the red, the gray, and the yellow show side by side. And if the width is less than 360 pixels, like around this way, I'm gonna have all these divs stacked on top of each other. What I do is I go back here to my code and I include a media query. You do that, you've learned that in HTML CSS class. Again, reminder, it's called media, at media screen, and minimum width is 361. So basically, if the minimum width is 361, I want the green. So basically, if I have a big screen, if the user has a big screen, I want the green, red, gray, and yellow to have width of 50%. Otherwise, I'm going to have all of them stacked on top of each other. Because by default, if you go up here, the width is 100% for each division. So let's refresh that. So if you look at that, this is what was simulated, how we would simulate a mobile phone. So 360. And if you think about it, okay, this is what it will look like on a mobile phone. And if I increase the screen, we now go into someone with a bigger screen space. So that's basically a quick demo of like how you would like start thinking about using these Flexbox properties to learn about how to create some very robust layouts in a very simple and elegant way. So I really highly recommend you check out Flexbox a little more if you want to design your site using your own layout tools, because I know we've taught you how to use Bootstrap, and now in this session we're teaching you how to create your own layout, custom layout.